days are over. And life is like a song. Oh, yeah, yeah, at last. The skies above are blue. My heart was wrapped up in clover. I found a dream that I could speak to, a dream that I can call my own. I found a thrill to press my cheek to, a thrill that I in heaven. For you are mine at last.
Oh, mare tu e pate, ane mare tu e pate, ma tua.
To the camera.
Oh no!
Come on!
How much did you
come
get?
On! Nothing. I just.
We take it all back.
I
just.
Over?
No.
I just turned it on. I have to. I've been.
Uncensored.
I've been instructed. This is Dawn's paying for this, man. Paying for the video abuse. What are you eating?
Delicious egg casserole.
It's really
made by
good.
Holly.
It's good stuff.
Holly did an awesome job.
It's delicious.
I thought, where's the mimosas, baby?
Did you just?
I know you drank the champagne last night, and you just don't want to give it.
No, the champagne
it.
Is
cheese.
Are you sick of trying to keep track of alcohol bottles?
Mom's like, here's the recipe.
Champagne's in the back of someone's car.
Oh, gosh.
I don't have a car.
It may even be Don's car.
What you doing?
I'm drawing.
What you drawing?
Drawing my toes and my nails.
Red toes.
Red hot,
hot smoking. Feel the sizzle.
It's a small.
Feel the sizzle.
Skylar's
oh, I didn't see you standing over there.
Pretty toes.
Pink toes.
Pink toes. What color is it? Red.
Green.
Green.
Green. Everything's either red. Green or
but don't judge.
Yeah. Sienna. Sienna.
What did I do with that?
The begging doggy. Sienna, what do you feel about Dawn and Brent getting married?
You have the same photographer we did?
Yeah.
Susan Muller?
Yep. The one with Carrie on the piano?
No.
I guess she blew it up and has it hanging in her little studio.
We have one guy missing.
Oh, sure.
We still have
no
one
problem.
Room.
Oh, one's
Where's
dressing.
Faye?
One's dressing.
Faye's dressing.
Right after the ceremony, you guys wanted to go where?
Children's Chapel.
Okay, we're going to check, see, there may be a wedding song.
Oh, really?
That's the
well, Sarah was going to check on that.
She was going to check. She thought there was a wedding.
So, we'll see you.
Thank you.
pass this to you, okay? And ask that you repeat after me. Gotcha. Okay. And then I'll ask for the next ring, place that on the Bible. No, I'll do that myself. Yeah, you're okay. I'll do that. All right? Does that sound good? Okay. You're going to have Brent's ring, right? Okay. So, and then from there, repeat after me. And then we'll have a blessing, a prayer. Yes. I'll wait for all of it. We'll do that. We don't have to rush any of this. We'll go as comfortably and as warmly as we can. So, we have a reading of the Irish blessing, like Brent Boynton. And Holly, that's right. I'm sorry.
So, where are we going to go? Up, down, here, middle, front, just right here.
Right here.
Just speak in. Really?
Wah, 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 wah. Where's Holly?
And be a part of that whole experience, okay? So if there's levity, there's levity. If there's humor, there's humor, right? That's part of it. That's all part of the good things of life. So let's bow together. Our God, our Father in heaven, it is our pleasure to stand and to sit together as family and friends, Brent and Don, and to recognize that this special moment in our lives, magical as it is, has very much the approval of your love and of your attention. And I just pray that as they continue this day in preparation and even more tomorrow, that your spirit would be about them in such a way that you would be a companion to bring peace and comfort to them, in the knowledge that not only are you appreciative of this experience for them, but also that you would bless them in ways that would be part of their lives. So bless us with that spirit that allows us to be at peace, that allows us to be unified for the purpose of glorifying you. We thank you for them, for their friends and family. Bless each of us until we meet again. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you, everyone. You're very good. Very patient. Thank you, Sarah.
That's not my much of an introduction. We just got to California. It's and we're in driving through Oakland, I think, so it's better that it is dark so we can't see the drive-bys happening around us. However, we're gonna go that way for a long time.
Thank you.
Satan.
Say hi.
Hi.
What you got in your hand? What is that?
Popcorn.
A popcorn? No, acorn.
Popcorn.
Acorn. Say hi.
Hi.
Say mommy.
Mommy.
Say awa.
Awa.
Say doo.
Doo.
You got a runny nose?
No.
No. I'm blowing nose.
First of all, I want to welcome all our guests and our friends and our new friends and family. And I'd like to propose a toast to Dawn and Brent. Your happiness is our happiness. Congratulations.
Yay. Thank you.
And to our new family, thank you. And to Michael and John, thank you very much for making this come true. We appreciate
thank
it.
Thank you very
Cheers.
Much.
Thank you. Well, I should say best wishes. You never congratulate
them.
Does that mean
etiquette,
after him?
Etiquette.
Etiquette. You have to go by the book, I'm told. Oh,
I want to thank everybody for being involved in our ceremony. And I have, as tokens of our appreciation, take care. We have gifts here for everyone, but I truly, truly appreciate everyone being here and enjoying this with us. And thank you, John and Michael, very much for making this wonderful and beautiful and everything.
You gifts.
Okay, you have anything to say?
I will.
Okay, okay.
Still trying to think of what to say.
Give me another drink.
Still have another minute.
Do my individual wing brush.
Okay, cool. Stand up. Hey, this is John.
Nice toast, Doctor.
Yeah.
I also would like to thank everyone for being here. John and Michael are not out here anymore. I've known them for many years, and they've done much more for me than just host a party during my wedding. So I'd like to thank especially John for helping with school and all that kind of stuff that I appreciate much, since that's what I do for my life now. Glad to have all my friends here. Ones who traveled far like Faye, and ones who traveled right down the street like Taylor. I'm glad that we're all generally in the same hemisphere rather than me being down in Florida. I'm glad to be back, and I'm glad that you guys are all here to, and able to make it and have a free weekend and all that kind of stuff to hang out and have a good time. So, thanks to everyone.
You missed the speech. They're out here.
Thanks, Brent.
They are. Oh, he did.
Nice.
Yeah. TSR. We'll both be drinking from that tonight, Albright.
Thank you.
Thanks, Albright. That's awesome.
I couldn't get a space.
That's
all right.
What is your time, Taylor?
You have to tell me later if that stands.
Yes.
Open? Stay in front of the camera.
Yeah, go ahead.
S-A-L-L. This is TSO.
That's quite Sal.
P. Taylor. Sal. Perfect.
Are you? We're not tassels, Don. You moved on from that board in your heart.
Professional bridesmaid.
Just in case you're missing somebody,
I'll do it.
I'll do it. I don't want to do it. I know what you mean.
I'm just kidding.
I'm not that
in my life. Not.
We should have moved to these like an hour
ago.
Like a personal test. He thinks it's all new. Ready on the boat. And I'm looking out. I can see Matt. He's pacing, and I'm like,
he's so nervous.
I'm up there, though. The bartender's like, would you like a drink? I'm like, oh, yeah.
We got time.
I had a drink on the boat until I had to go out. I knew what I looked like, so, you know.
What
did
you guys
talk to worry about?
When we got married. Janine was on the boat getting ready, and then she came off the boat and walked up the aisle, and I was standing there.
You got married like Donald.
And I just remember my cousin was my best man, and he's standing behind me. He just kept going, don't lock your knees, don't lock your knees, don't lock your knees. He goes, if you get nervous and you lock your knees, you're going to pass out.
So she's going to look so beautiful when she...
And then I look over, and Dawn is standing across to me, and she goes,
Dawn, you
stop it. And I'm like, what are you talking about? And she said, I was just sitting there going like this. I'm just playing with my pants. And she's like, stop it. I'm like, what? And she's like, blame your pants.
I'm glad you didn't even answer by blame your pants.
Yeah. No, they were out. So it was really fun.
I
have
this kind of like a
And then he pronounced her name wrong. He called her Janine.
Janine.
Keep on
my Janine.
Head.
Yeah.
First it was Jamon.
It's just Janine, whatever.
She was an
aunt Jemima. And then a pair, we have wild parrots in Florida, and we're on guest's head during
the
ceremony.
It's
yeah.
Yeah. So nobody can hear anything.
But see, that's the thing. We never got to watch it.
So we will not have any parrots walking at Donald's wedding tomorrow.
You can use it all the time.
No parrots.
Always carry them on. Spanish word.
No, you gotta hold my hand. That's the rule. There's water. Gotta hold my hand. Yes. Everywhere. No, you gotta hold my hand.
No.
Yes. Sorry. Use your finger. Is that whole thing? Oh, that whole thing is chocolate. Just eating it out of the boat. You could, yeah, it looks like it's all chocolate. She loves being cold. It's
really Mom.
Mommy's up there. Sarah.
Kawa.
Sarah.
Oh, happy.
Airplane. Up. Up. Jump. Just don't back up too much, Tom.
Not the place.
Be ready to grab, Jason.
Dope.
Uh oh.
She'll come out.
Not that way.
Actually, you're pretty well built.
Where's Lori?
We could all stand on one side.
She should work today.
That's
all right.
I was just looking at Tom and thinking, oh.
Don't get dizzy there, Scott.
Woo! Whoa! Look at the split!
We'll have to go up there this summer.
You got a runny nose.
Doing all these little tricks.
Oh, yay. Oh, boy.
Woo! You want to get your feet all wet? You got a runny nose.
And the knee board,
wet too.
And the beers, and we're all set.
All right, guys, I went to a buddy of mine's wedding last September in Boston. And we all stood around and roasted the groom. So, no, since you guys know Brent better than I do, I got to hear some really good stories now that it's just the guys.
Save it for my speech tomorrow.
He was a dud.
He was a dud.
We tried to corrupt him for years.
See, now that, yeah. Now we're talking stories.
Cool, thanks.
Sure.
Oh, you dropped it again.
Please get it.
These are the things we need to work out.
Actually, gonna need those. Mm-hmm. He wants to just kind of do his own thing at his own pace. His own
Here are
business.
My hours. If he can make it, he can make Carol. It. If he can't, you know
about
he's back on. Yeah.
I have a friend of mine that just went out to, she went out to Maui for some yoga instruction for 2 weeks. And I mean, tons of people just, and she's just stayed in a little bed and breakfast place, you know, not a resort, not a really
I know,
expensive
yeah.
place.
But where do they live? I don't know where anybody lives.
They're from Tennessee.
We had a great
oh,
time.
I don't know where they're staying then.
Anyway, I went out there. I went out about 5 days early, and I ended up going on this.
I'll recruit your mom. Jan.
And so now I'll go out there a little bit more.
Jan.
It's a long way to go from the Midwest, though.
Yeah.
To squash your whole suspicion.
Really good job.
Did we really?
because we thought that it was just
that's
not
why
happening.
I made the little announcements for the whole little shindig at the waterfront restaurant. I'm like, just try to throw her off track as best we can. But you know, I know Sarah and I were also with all the coordination. We're very sorry we couldn't come up and be with you during your shower. So we definitely wanted to have something special for you with all of your other out of town friends. So we just want to enjoy and celebrate with you. We love you, and
you're getting married.
You're getting married.
So we just hope everybody just has a good time. We're serving coffee and Baileys. That's kind of been a traditional beverage for a very long time. Probably starting in Germany. But so we're just kind of celebrating everything with our life. So enjoy, and we'll open some presents here in a few minutes, and that's always fun.
Yay!
Yes, I am. Don't be wrong. Two almost. I haven't seen him in over 3 years. Been a little bit of a break here and there, but he's still my boy. Congrats.
Thank you, buddy.
So basically what we can do now is, does anybody have any embarrassing stories about Dawn? Come on, come on, come on. Or anything you'd just like to say. Wow, you've made an impression on people.
We're at the waterfront in Camden. Thank you, boy. Camden, Maine, or for something, something, something.
It's been wonderful. We've gone to sit and been together. And I'm very proud to be her mother. And I wouldn't want another
daughter.
That's the
one.
She's the best.
Oh.
Yay. Hey, Mom. Moms are awesome. Moms always make me feel good.
We didn't have Kleenex. That's the one thing we didn't plan for.
Shoot.
Kleenex. Kleenex.
So toast to Brent, good luck tomorrow. I know you're nervous as hell, but Dawn's a good girl, and good luck. Here's a toast for you.
Dawn and I are cousins. We're like third cousins, but that doesn't matter. We're friends. We knew each other when we were little. We played jump rope and stuff together, and at her grandparents' house, they had this boat we would play with. And then we got to know each other. She moved back to town in her high school, and we got to hang out together. And she would come over, and we'd go out, and we had this song that we would sing.
Oh, God. sing it.
There's a tear in my beer,
and I'm crying for you, dear. We're on my lonely mind.
To see you so happy with Brent is just so heartwarming, and it's just wonderful. I think it's great.
Yay.
And as your mom said, you're the best.
I don't really know you yet, but Dawn and I are enjoying our time in Maine, and we're probably going to come back next year, so we'll get a chance to hang out, and best of luck to you in the new marriage. Adios.
There's two songs, actually.
I don't know if it's good.
That one is
Buffalo Stance. I don't know what it was about those two songs, but Dawn and I used to listen, and we memorized all those songs.
We
went to Davenport, remember?
Yep.
And we played this. It was a single.
Yep. It was a single. In your car. The whole entire way. It was an hour drive.
A single. And we rewound that thing 1,000 times. It was so sad.
We keep going. Dawn likes to listen to certain songs.
But the thing is, you have to know about Dawn is she used to be in dance in Texas. So I think that's kind of where it all came from.
Drill team.
Drill team.
Yes.
Remember in your basement, we would like do some dance routines in front of, because she had like
Dawn, what
this
do you
whole
know?
Wall of mirrors in her basement, and we pushed the couch away, and we had this whole big room with just a big, huge mirror.
Yeah.
What do we do? We tried to make a routine.
Dawn, hot dance.
Never...
Well, I just have to say to Dawn and Brent, I wish you the best. Many joyous days, as many as Janine and I have already had. Many, many. So enjoy your lives. There goes the cell phone. I'm being videotaped by Tom giving a little dedication to Dawn and Brent, and you call.
we met in basic training, and when, you know, everybody's getting to know each other a little bit, and we were stationed in Germany, so we were flown there right before the Gulf War started, and, you know, we all get off the plane, and we're at our new barracks, and, you know, you see a familiar face, and you say, ooh, be my roommate, because it's the only familiar face, you know, that's, like, you know, family, that's home. And so, you know, we're getting to know each other, and she starts telling me about that buttermilk biscuits, and I'm like, yeah, and you're from, yeah, from Boston, I don't know what you're talking about. And it was very interesting. But Dawn, yeah, I thought, here's the little farm girl, and I was like, the Boston City girl, I'm like, I don't know about this, but like they say, opposites attract, and I do want to add, I
go for
it. Oh, no. I've never, you know, I don't have a sister. Well, I didn't think I had a sister, but, I mean, Dawn and I have been through a lot. See, cut it out. And, you are my sister, and I hate that you live here, but I'm really happy that I know how to get here. So, I would sit here and lecture and tell Brent to, you know, take care of you and this and that, but I'm just going to tell you, keep him in mind, because as long as you do that and paint him right, you'll be fine.
Oh, the fella's right.
I know, but he lives in Texas.
Sir, can I see the size feet you have?
Brent will remember in years to come.
Brent's the one that
wait,
he'll
never forget.
Thank you so much.
This. For everyone that doesn't know, somewhere on Dawn's body there's a Woodstock, and somewhere on Brent's there's a Snoopy.
Yeah, that was kind of a good giveaway. It's a funny card. Here's my chance to get sentimental. I want to thank you for coming into my brother's life. You've made him the happiest I've ever seen him. Thank you for deciding to come to Maine and bringing you and Skylar into my family's life. We all love the both of you so dearly. You've been a wonderful friend and now sister. You'll have someone to gang up on, Brent, forever and ever. Welcome to the family. If you haven't already noticed, our family takes care of each other, any problem, big or small. So if you need anything, we're there for you. I'm so happy, Brent, we're cologne that night. You two were meant for each other. I love you lots and lots. With all the craziness, try to have fun tomorrow. This is your day. And Brent's to your sister, Jamie.
Oh. I had to get a little skimpy on this, so.
Jackie,
I knew Brent would, that would be the first thing to send to me.
This is the one that I was looking for. And then you're out.
Well, it's a really
and you are the awesomest mom on the planet for saying that. That's nice. Yay, Brent. Oh, wow. Ooh. That's awesome.
Are you the video photographer?
Say something.
I'm fat on tape. I don't want to get this too close.
That would make you look 10 pounds fatter.
When Brent met me today, I haven't seen him in 3.5 years. I was on the massage table getting a deep tissue massage. That's how I get that. Oh,
I didn't make that my grandma did. I love it. It's kind of a tradition in my family.
She handed me a rock. There was no explanation necessary for this rock. I knew from that day that I was Dawn's sister and always would be. So I'm giving this rock back to Dawn in a fashion that she can wear and enjoy.
Oh my God.
And someday pass it on to someone else fitting. I almost can't give it to you because I love it.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
It came from the same
jar
of rocks here. So anybody who knows the story, wonderful. And if you don't, you can ask Dawn. I knew I'd make you proud.
Thank you.
you'll enjoy visiting for a little bit longer and have some snacks and some champagne and some decaf coffee.
Lonely champagne glass.
I'll get rid of it. I'll get rid of this one. Julian's tablespoon.
Oh, and here's Don. Here you go, Janine. Finish this one too.
Janine. Done.
Finished.
Oh, no. Hey, Amy, gone blonde and hit the bottle, baby. You drank so much, your hair turned blonde.
Yeah.
Amy,
finish that one.
That's toast.
I drank mine.
No, to empty glass.
To empty glass?
No!
Drink it! It's a tablespoon, Amy. Little.
Give me that.
You know how much I've had?
Give me that.
This? Here, yeah. Sarah will hook you up.
Here, wait. Can we
do it? I don't.
Okay, wait.
Say bye-bye.
Bye-bye. All gone.
Eat that. Except I left all the stems on because I didn't want to pick them all off.
All right. Look, please continue. Nothing happened.
Hey. Where's Brent?
That's my dog.
I know. We're looking for it.
It's my dog.
He was here
just
Where is he? Where's Alvo?
No one knows.
Dude, he just like...
He jumped in the water, I think.
Dude, he said he was getting cold feet, he jumped in the water.
Hey man, Mom, do you feel like having
all balls?
All balls.
All balls.
I'm not going after you.
This is the father of the bride.
And Jeremy and...
Get the very nervous bride over there.
Oh yeah, hell yeah.
She's a...
All balls!
All balls! Give her a kiss!
On camera!
On camera!
Patron of honor right here! Make out on camera! Oh, look how cute they look.
This is for
me and him are going to wake up in bed tomorrow.
So then I took my heart. You puked?
Bathroom. You got rid of the bad shit.
You missed your car.
I peeked it back into my glass.
I didn't know that he was your dad, and I was very disrespectful.
But he got over it. He's from Dallas,
Pittsburgh, so
Cowboys come. There's a college education to give it to you right here.
Teamwork goes hoodwinked and
done. There's a
you made Dawn cry a lot.
Dawn's not happy with me right about now.
Why?
I'm too drunk for her liking.
She's going home.
Her dad was too drunk for her liking.
Got drunk with the old man-in-law, huh?
Took him out,
but... Yeah, we did. All I had to do was stick my Penn State friends on him, and he was all done.
Heaven came.
There you go. Anybody want Domino's?
Yeah, I'm going to change my clothes.
Okay. But no, it worked really well.
Actually,
oh, it's on Brent.
What?
Brent, what are we waiting for?
Dinner.
Pizza. Hey, what are you thinking? What's going through your head?
Don's mad at
me. Don, why is Don mad at you, Brent? Well, I don't know.
This is brought to you by Wild Blueberry. Eat it.
That's my beer. It's the Sea Dog Brewing Company. Brent.
What?
So, did you ever think that you would get your married?
There's many years of hard work.
Many years, for us all.
And
co-work.
Kelly. Kelly. Who is that for the record? Because we don't know who he is officially on camera.
I picked him up overseas on the street.
Right.
Have you been drinking tonight, sir?
Not quite. Make him walk the line.
You've been drinking since like 2 o'clock this afternoon.
You're honestly watching last night with all the UI.
Brought to you by Blueberry Beer.
Tomase Productions.
Brought to you by
Maine Blueberries.
This is what you're brought to you by
Beer. Beer and Domino's.
Sea Dog Brewery. Wild Blueberry Flavor. New season only this summer.
It did.
It did.
But they sold like
the brewery's still open.
Yeah.
Yeah, that
was. Wait
it.
It's like a.
Where do they live?
You remember that stuff? You have the baby story? I worked at a lab, and we used to, every Friday, we're all divided up in teams, and we used to, they give us money, and we'd buy lunch and cook it for everybody, so we got this big elaborate thing. My friend would stand up and be like, what's for lunch this week? She'd say, baby. And so when she found out I was working in the NICU, she goes, now you can have a constant supply of babies for all your fun gatherings.
Yeah, that was,
come on, I gotta see.
That story that,
you're gonna enjoy this like years down the road.
So Joyce, what kind of flowers are in your bouquet? What did Dawn just tell you? Because I missed it on camera.
A yellow flower.
Yellow rose?
A yellow rose. And why did she give you the yellow rose?
Because it's my mom's.
Her favorite, her mom's favorite flower. And it's also the rose of Texas. The yellow rose of Texas. And you're from Texas.
Okay, where are the roses? Show me the rose. Ooh. She's the only one that gets the yellow roses.
She's special. Okay.
And these guys just driving by in suits just decided to come take pictures of everybody.
Yeah, they just decided to.
We just saw a bunch of ladies who needed to stop and see closer up.
Dawn's daddy. Really close shot of Dawn. Shame.
Testing the veil.
What are you going to be doing in that veil, baby?
Shaking it.
Exactly.
Oh, particular one little 2-year old blonde girl.
So when you're walking and stuff, so you do that. So when you do give hugs, if you don't, they're gonna rip it off.
Yeah.
Is anybody in the gallery yet?
No. I saw those pictures though. They're with that hat.
I'm like,
hat. She looks so old with that hat on. Look at all that dress. Brent's got to get all the way in that dress. What's going on, girls? Oh, you're going to sit. That's part of having a video camera. Yeah. Here, we'll do one shot.
Hi.
Hi. I can't get myself in there.
Here.
I don't want to be in it. Here, wait.
There we go. See, now I'm on the tape. And now I'm gone from the tape.
Okay. See.
Is he taking the sound off or?
He'll do all sorts of bizarre, strange, amazing things with the tape. I don't know how he thinks of half the things he does. I'll help you out with that.
With all my heart.
Dun, 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 dun.
With all Don's heart.
Not your heart.
With Don's heart.
Can't have him. That's the way to be, man.
Let's make sure the ring is actually in here. This is Brent's ring. Nice, huh?
Oh, yeah.
No, hi, Don.
What's happening?
We're going to head over now.
Okay.
And we're going to go up the back way.
Okay.
Through that back door.
Sneaking of the bride into the church.
Yes, making sure that Brent does not view the bride. And the car is trying to hit us. There's Tom right there.
Hey!
Look at you, we're dead.
It's kind of good here.
gathered here today to unite Brent Albright and Don Kleiner in marriage.
Skylar.
Greetings and welcome to family and friends. This is a beautiful occasion, made beautiful by your entrance. I'm Jerry Stone. I've been married myself 33 years and taught school for a number of years here, running a preschool, been an ordained minister for 25 years.
Skylar.
I'm delighted to be part of the experience together here, as well as the family, and to embrace this very solemn and yet celebration experience with you. I welcome family and friends, and we're glad to be here with you too. Today we're asked to celebrate and to bless the marriage of Brent and Don. I welcome every one of you here in the spirit of joy, and recognize that during this special service, love is made real. And that in that love is someone to smile and laugh with, and certainly to share a life's journey. Someone you can count on and who will never let you down.
To bear witness is a thing of eternal value. There's no question in my mind what that means. We here as family and friends are here to bear witness of the great love that we cannot miss. It is obvious that these two have for each other. And today we're simply here
to give full support to you, Brent and Don. We're here to bear witness of your love and your desire to be joined in this beautiful experience together. Life doesn't always go as easy and as smoothly as I hope this service will, and I know it will. And so, family and friends, we need to be prepared. And this is an important part of our value today in our society, to support people in their relationships. And that's part of the responsibility I charge family and friends with this particular day. Be there for this beautiful couple in their joy and when they need you the most in some of the difficulties. Hey, Skylar, can you hear me? Skylar, hi. Can you come up here with me?
Yeah.
Once you are. Why not? This is a united family already. Skylar, I have a beautiful book for you. Your feet? Oh, what happened? Your shoe? Let's see if that best man can find that. Oh, a girl needs a shoe on at a time like this. Oh.
Okay.
How's that? Hey, Skylar. Can you feel that soft kitty? Can you help one? You see this little soft kitty?
You can take this book with you, okay? You want to go down? Okay. This book, Skylar, there you go.
And look down.
That book, Skylar, is what this marriage is about. Soft, wonderful experience together. We wanted to include Skylar in that. On Thursday, I asked a couple of my preschoolers about marriage. Yeah, so precious, those kiddos. And one of them, his name is Eric, said, he's age 5. He said, marriage is when you get your girl and don't have to give her back to your parents. One of my others, this is a girl, Emily, who's also 5, and she's in kindergarten with us. She said, Mr. Jerry, once I'm done with kindergarten, I'm gonna find myself a husband. There's something simple in the experience we have together, but yet very, very preciously important. And I'm of the belief, Brent and Don, that marriage is ordained of God. That is where I begin, and it isn't just because I'm a minister. I try to live my own marriage that way. I believe God ordains marriage for us spiritually, socially, and certainly for our material well-being. And I believe also that it's essential that human families come together in relationships that are genuine and whole. I could share with you, and I've thought a lot, what would I share with you two? And I've so much enjoyed meeting both of you. Brent, I've known you for a long time, and you have a very precious jewel you're holding on to right now. Absolutely. And as I've been with you, I've been wondering, what would I share? I could share some trite things with you, you know, about how marriage takes, you know, the two of you holding hands together, walking into the sunset. I could go on forever, I suppose. And what I want to share with you is an experience that I've shared before in other settings like this, but one that I feel impressed to share with you. And so I want to tell you that when I was in high school, I lived at a home for boys. That isn't so important, except it's quite unique taking 40 boys and house parents to Baxter State Park up here in Maine to climb Mount Tarden and do the rivers and all this and that. Well, during my sophomore year, where I was at this home, we did that. We went as a big family, and we climbed Mount Tarden. And I loved every minute of that experience. I've climbed it many times, even took my girls up there once. I'll tell that story another time. They didn't really relish it as much as I did. But as I climbed this mountain, I recognized, as I looked around, that humans had infiltrated this place. There were candy wrappers, etc. about. And then as I continued to climb, I really got caught, as a young man, in the immensity of the space. It almost frightened me, to be honest with you. I almost felt claustrophobic at first. This place is going to close in on me. And then as I climbed further and came to the Rose Springs and recognized the summit ahead of me, I recognized that we're going to make this. We're going to make it to the summit. We're going to the top. And this was these boys with us. And finally, I got to the summit. And it was at that point at which I looked down over Chimney Pond. Some of you know what I'm talking about. And as I looked down at Chimney Pond, I saw this gracious, enormous bird. And as I continued to watch that bird, I could see it diving down for a hapless creature along the shore of that small lake. And as I watched it, what surprised me and amazed me was the mobility of that bird. And then as I looked more closely, I recognized it was an American bobby. And it hit me so remarkably that although broken relationships had occurred in my life and my family, that if I will seek relationships that work as two wings of a giant bird, then life could bring success. And that's what I want to offer, is that as I watched this bird, it had these two wings, and these two wings were working in concert together for the sake of what the purpose was for this bird. And that was to bring it to its full potential. And that's what I want to offer you in very simple terms. And that is that as you work together, as you unite together, respecting each other's differences, recognizing that that kind of diversity really makes you beautiful and makes for you what is your future possibilities. And then unite together in purpose in all that you do. It won't always be easy, but it is an opportunity for you to today, as you hold hands, as you commit yourself to God, as you solemnize that with ring, and in the presence of this holy place, you can reach the full potential of your life, individually and together, and as you join Skylar and whatever that future might be for you. That's what I offer you. I offer you that as humbly as I can, recognizing that that's the kind of commitment that life calls for. We now move to the richness of this wedding ceremony, then. Facing each other. Brent, do you take this woman to be your wedded wife? And do you promise before God and this company that you will love her, honor her, comfort and keep her in sickness and in health, and that forsaking all others for her alone, will you perform unto her all of the duties and respect that a husband graciously bestows upon his wife?
I do.
And Don, do you take this man to be your wedded husband? And do you promise before God and this company that you will love him, honor him, comfort and keep him in sickness and in health, and that forsaking all others for him alone, Will you perform unto him all of the duties and respect that a wife graciously bestows upon her husband?
I do.
Repeat after me, Brent. From this moment, I, Brent Adam Albright.
From this moment, I, Brent Adam Albright.
Take you, Don and Kleiner.
Take you, Don and Kleiner.
To be my wife and my best friend.
To be my wife and my best friend.
My confidant, my soulmate.
My confidant, my soulmate.
I pledge to trust, honor, and courage.
I trust you.
I pledge to
trust, honor,
and courage.
And courage.
And support you through best of times.
And support you through best of times.
And the worst of times.
And the worst of times.
I promise to work at our love.
I promise to work at our love.
And always make you a priority in my life.
And to always make you a priority in my life.
Come what may.
Come what may.
I will always be there.
Come what may, I will always be there.
And remember why we came together this day. With all my heart.
With all my heart.
I will love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
I love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
And Don, repeat after me. From this moment, I, Don and Kleiner.
From this moment, I, Don and Kleiner.
Take you, Brent Adam Albright.
Take you, Brent Adam Albright.
To be my husband, my best friend.
To be my husband, my best friend.
My confidant, my soulmate.
My confidant, my soulmate.
I pledge to trust, honor, and courage.
I pledge to trust, honor, and encourage.
And support you through the best of times.
And support you through the best of times.
And the worst of times.
And the worst of times.
I promise to work at our love.
I promise to work at our love.
And always make you a priority in my life.
And always make you a priority in our life.
Come what may.
Come what may.
I will always be there.
I will always be there.
And remember why we came together this day.
And remember why we came together this day.
With all my heart.
With all my heart.
I will love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
I will love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
We now move to the ring ceremony. Jason, you bear the ring that binds Don, Brent. This ring is a circle. It's a symbol of the unbroken love between the two of you. May this ring be a daily reminder to you, Don, of the vows that you have made to each other and your resolve to live together in unity, love, and happiness. Brent, good afternoon.
Don, I give you this ring.
As a token of my love.
As a token of my love.
It signifies that our souls.
It signifies that our souls.
Are joined in lifelong ties.
Are joined in lifelong ties.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I be wed.
I be wed.
This ring, like the other, is made of precious gold. A symbol of the precious love between the both of you. May this ring be a daily reminder to you, Brent, of the vows that you also have made and that you resolve to live together in unity and love and happiness. Take this ring on. Are you okay with that? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Brent, I give you this ring.
Brent, I give you this ring.
As a token of my love.
As a token of my love.
It signifies that our souls.
It signifies that our souls
are joined in lifelong ties.
Are joined in lifelong ties.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I be wed.
I be wed.
May you be a blessing and comfort to each other. Sharers of each other's dreams. Consolers of each other's sorrows. Helpers to each other in life's difficulties. May you encourage each other in whatever you set out to achieve. May you trust each other, trust life, and be unafraid. May you love each other and offer love and support to those around you. So it is, Lord God, that we offer this special blessing in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
We have another special blessing, the Irish blessing, which will be read by Holly Hoffmaster and Brent Boynton.
May the road rise to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your fields and until we meet again. May God hold you in the palm of his hand. May God be with you and bless you. May you see your children's children. May you be poor in misfortune, rich in blessings. May you know nothing but happiness from this day forward.
May the road rise to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the warm rays of the sun fall upon your home. May the hand of a friend always be near. May green be the grass you walk on. May blue be the skies above you. May pure be the joys that surround you. May true be the hearts that love you.
Brent and Don, by exchanging vows and rings, you have pledged your friendship and your commitment of love, each of you in the presence of this company of friends and family. You have now mutually pledged yourselves to each other in the commitment of marriage. By the power and authority vested in me by the state of Maine, and by the power and authority vested in me by the Lord Jesus Christ, I now pronounce you husband and wife. And I kiss you. Friends and family, it is with great pleasure that I introduce to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Brent Albright.
Thank you.
Thank you. Hey, Amelia, how you doing?
Congratulations.
Thank you. John. Hi. Thank you.
Hi, Lou.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Hey, Peter.
Hi. Hi. Great ceremony.
Thank you.
Hi.
Nice to
see
you.
Nice to meet you.
Hi.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Give me a hug. Thank you, John. Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you, John. Pat.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Glad you can make it. Hey, Jelly.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you, Beth. You're not. Hey, Amanda.
Congratulations.
What's going on, John? Thanks for coming. Congratulations. Thank you. You hug Lexley. Thanks for coming, Roger. Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you. Thanks, John. Thank you. You missed my toast at your camp.
Yeah.
Oh, you have a video?
Good video.
I'm
going to
have a video. Thanks, Michael. Thanks for everything.
He hooked me up.
I guess I can't call you Rumi anymore. Thank you, man. Thanks for coming. Hey,
Mr. Brent, how are you doing?
Give me a hug. Hey, Cindy. Thank you for coming. Thank you.
This is awesome.
Thanks for coming, Johnny.
Oh, you're welcome. Congratulations.
Hey, Beth.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Mr. Salmon.
Congratulations, Brent.
Thank you. Howard.
Good luck, Brent.
Thank you. Don, this is Howard.
Hi, Maria.
Hi.
Clara.
Hi, darling. How are you?
Good.
My little boy, all grown up.
Oh, yeah.
No more lollipops.
Oh, I was so calling for lollipops.
Hi.
Congratulations, dear.
Thank you.
We're so happy for you.
Thank you. You guys look beautiful.
Thank you. Hey, little Tom.
That's good for the most part.
Yeah, that's okay. I was more bothered by Sky.
She was so cute. Seriously, as soon as she ran up, she was
I feel bad if you haven't seen now.
You guys look beautiful.
Thank you.
Okay, I'll see you soon.
So happy for you.
So long. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thanks for coming.
Yeah, good job.
Thanks for coming.
Oh, yes.
We're
being present.
Thank you.
Best wishes.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thanks for coming.
Oh, thanks for having us. Congratulations.
Hey, Leslie. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Glad you made it. Hey, Doc. Thanks. Glad you can make it.
Thank you so much. Skylar, I'm sorry.
No, this is Don.
Don.
Skylar's
the little one.
Skylar's the little one.
Best wishes.
Thank you so much. Nice
to meet you. Thank you. Glad to make it.
Keep it. Hold on to that. Congrats, buddy.
I was
put it in your pocket.
Good to see you, Mark.
you.
Congrats.
Hey,
Dr. Chan. Thanks. Thanks for coming.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Hi, Trish. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's beautiful. Hi, I'm Trish. This is my husband who works with Brent.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Congratulations. Oh, that's sweet. You're beautiful. Absolutely beautiful.
Hello. Yes.
I love her. The baby's 5 weeks old. 5 weeks old. Huh? She called me.
Yeah.
And then we're supposed to all
just like a close up.
Yeah. And then we're supposed to go down.
Do you have your bike hooked up?
Yeah.
Up there.
They're coming out.
Go?
Okay.
Sunsetting out.
This is just for you. Oh my goodness.
No, I have Lori's story.
Where did we go?
Right ahead.
Oh my gosh.
Reception down the street.
What do you do after weddings?
So what was this? Do you, I was
we don't have got to figure out what the score is first.
I figured, Jason you guys weren't going to even show up.
There was a minute left.
Da 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 da
Welcome to the Camden Yacht Club. Well, I'll tell you, when I left Woolwich, it was pouring down the rain. I think somebody likes our riding room today. What do you think? Look at this weather we've got, huh? That's fantastic. Everybody ready to have a good time this afternoon? Everybody ready to have some surf and turf and some lobster and some wine and some dancing and some fun? Y'all on Brent and Dawn's side for this, right? You ready? I think they deserve a round of applause before they even come in the room. There's one special guest I would like to announce, and I'm not sure if she's in the room or she's in the tent, but I'm going to announce her anyway, and I'd like you to give her a nice round of applause. Brent's grandmother is here this afternoon, Evelyn Bailey, so please give Evelyn a nice round of applause. And at this time, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to begin the introductions of the bridal party and ask that you please welcome them warmly as I introduce them. I'd like to start by introducing Dawn's mother and her husband, so please give a warm welcome to Carol and Gary Johnson. Please give a warm welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Dawn's father, Mr. Gerald Kleiner. Please give a warm welcome and a rousing round of applause to Brent's parents, Dr. Terry and Jan Albright. Our junior bridesmaid and groomsman, fifth groomsman, and I'm going to introduce our flower girl too, although I know she's already in the room somewhere, Miss Schuyler, Joyce Kleiner, and Chris Gross. Now we find ourselves at our groomsmen and our bridesmaids, and I'll ask that you welcome them as warmly as you did the parents and the grandparents and the junior bridesmaids and so on. Let me start by introducing Don Simpkins and Tom to ask me about my new baby, Saladin Sr. Please give a nice round of applause to Jamie Albright and Jason Fay. A warm welcome for Sarah Renna and Chris Hart. Our best man and our matron of honor, ladies and gentlemen, Jason Taylor and Janine Tompkins. To make some noise for these two, because the weather broke for them. It's their special day and they deserve it. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to announce to you Mr. and Mrs. Brent Albright.
As long as I live, I will.
Tom's like, please set something aside for
you. Oh, good. I'm starving. Yeah, I hope you...
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore. When the world seems to shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore. Bells will ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling, and you'll sing beat of Zelda. Hearts will play, tippy-tippy-tay, tippy-tippy-tay, like a guitar and a when the stars make you drool, just like a pastry fazool, that's amore. When you dance down the street with a cloud of your feet, you're in love.
Good evening, everybody. How about this great improvement in weather we're having? So I'm very pleased for Brent and Don. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Jason. As the best man, I have the honor of making some remarks about Brent, as well as some wishful words of wisdom for Brent and Don and their future together. Now, Brent. You know what's expected of me, so don't be surprised if by the end of the speech a lot of people here think a lot less of you. So. I think it would only be fitting if I started at the beginning, which happened to be August 18th, 1977. Now, doing some research on this date, I found it very interesting to note that Elvis Presley died only 2 days before Brent was born. So I found it out with one ear and in with the next. I met Brent about 13 years ago when we played baseball on rival teams, but it wasn't until high school that I really became good friends with Brent. We actually shared history class together, and at first I wasn't sure if I was in class or I was in a skit for Saturday Night Live. Brent here had a great knack for reciting every word to every episode of Saturday Night Live with his friend here, Mr. Boynton. So they would sit there in class and laugh and point in and laugh in hysterics, and the rest of us would just stand there in bewilderment. Now, Don, as you might imagine, Brent did not have a girlfriend at this time. As a young man, Brent had many high aspirations. He wanted to go to college, and he wanted to promote some culture in his life, and that's why we took 4 years of French class together. During that 4 years, we not only learned how to speak and read French, but we also learned and wasted a lot of our time developing our own language, which was a combination of French, English, and gibberish. Kelleskele F, as we might say. At the time, I thought Brent's last name was very fitting for the field of study that he wanted to go into, which was medicine. Dr. Albright. Well, my opinion changed one day when he decided to add a quart of oil to his parents' Ford Explorer. You see, when Brent drives, he just doesn't go from point A to point B. He tears off from every stoplight like he's running a quarter mile drag race. So on this day, he took off from Route 52, flying up to the gears. He probably hit 60 miles an hour, and the next thing you know, the hood flies open on his parents' Explorer. Put a pretty good dent in the top of the Explorer, but he safely pulled the vehicle to the side. And from that day going forward, we didn't refer to him as Albright, we referred to him as Half Bright. This was not the only thing that Brent took a bad rap for. For a while there, we thought he was a very withdrawn person. He didn't want to hang out with us, but that was not the case at all. Brent was a very active, energetic person. He just didn't operate in the same time zone as the rest of us. What I mean by this is that while most of us operated between 7 a.m. and 10 p.m., Brent was awake from 1 p.m. to 4 a.m. So I can call many a time going over to Brent's house at noon, going out, we're going to go out and hang out for the afternoon, wherever the case may be, and Brent's mom and Jan have to go up and wake him up. But we always knew when he was awake in the evening, we would drive up the driveway and we'd see a green hue coming from his window, which was his, probably at the time, probably a radioactive TV set glaring from the window. One of the most fondest memories that I think we ever had is when we went to Fort Lauderdale for spring break. Now, before you get too many thoughts in your mind, this was not a custom prepaid round-trip airfare ticket. No, this was four guys from the University of Maine driving to Florida in a Toyota T100 pickup truck. Yeah. We were meeting Brent's friends in Penn State, and supposedly there was this place for us to stay when we got there, and that's all we were. So we met up in Penn State, and we hung out there for the night, and we proceeded to Florida. Unfortunately, there was somebody there, one of Brent's friends, that did have a place for us to stay. Unfortunately, at the time, not everyone was 21. We did manage to still have a good time, and just for the record, UMaine crushed Penn State in the drinking contest. Yeah! 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 Yeah!
It was in the shed. All right, who's in the shed?
All right. Now, I'm sure you're all curious about the bachelor party that we had last weekend for Brent. Now, to maintain Brent's integrity, we can't go into a lot of details in this. Guys, we had a great time. Oh, and that reminds me, Chris, you still owe me $20 for that last dance you had. No, but in all seriousness, Brent has been a great friend over the years, and it's really a great honor to be your best man, and I really wish both you and Don much happiness for the year to come, years to come. You have a great family.
I'm sure how to follow that. I'm really not going to try to top that. I don't think I could at this point. I've said a lot of things since I've been up here in Maine. I've done a lot of talking, a lot of crying, shared enough stories, and really all I want to say to Don and Brent today is, you know, they say that everyone has a soulmate. Basically, that journey to find your soulmate is filled with challenges. Challenges beyond belief. We all have our own challenges and demons to deal with. And what I have found with my own experience and my wonderful husband Matt, and what I've seen with my friends and with Dawn and Brent, is basically the greater the challenge, the greater the reward. Dawn and Brent, really, I wish you a lifetime of challenges that will benefit you with a lifetime of rewards to include basically health, wealth, and love. So, to Dawn and Brent. Thank you. late. Becky stole me a bottle. It's good.
Turn everyone's attention to our wedding cake, where Dawn and Brent are prepared to cut two pieces and to feed one another as husband and wife. Don't they look great? It's very exciting. So we are going to ask them to pick up their knife, one hand from each of them, and a little music for them to cut the cake too. Thank you. you all please give a nice round of applause to Dawn and her father, Jeremy, please.
Brent, Dawn, congrats, Brent. You're a lucky man. Dawn, you're awesome. You guys are meant for each other. Cheers, salute. Enjoy your life.
Yeah!
dumbest dance in the whole world.
No, there's worse ones, like the chicken dance.
Chicken dance is worse.
Chicken dance is happening. No, it's not. It's happening.
Really?
Well, someone beat it in. Electric slide is out. Chicken dance is in.
I'm gonna stop singing now.
Thank you.
Yeah. Brent's gonna give it to you.
Yeah! How do you talk about that?
Although he doesn't have much rhythm, but I'll keep it.
No, I don't have any rhythm.
Did you eat some aspirin before you start drinking that?
Have you told the story about that present you gave to Dawn today on film?
No.
That was a great story.
You should.
No.
I'll make you cry again. Okay.
You can't trick me. I'm on to you. No, I don't want
nothing,
them on film. No. Edit,
film.
edit.
No, do you want to say anything to them, though?
Oh.
No.
I mean, it's a great
story. Okay, take one. No.
Although you did give a speech, but now you got to do a shoot.
Should I say my speech again?
No. Well, go ahead, yeah.
No, I'm not going to give that.
You know by heart?
No. Okay. I wrote it right after they told me I was supposed to give a speech. I didn't know. I'm brain cramping at the moment. You can really stop. I don't know. I've talked too much and gave too many little speeches and made too many people cry. So.
It was a very nice toast.
Thank you. Thank you for that. I need a break. No, that was making me sick looking at people in slow motion.
Oh, you're recording.
Yeah.
You could do the, this is better probably.
Look at
well,
that.
Night vision, unicorn.
What's that?
Is night vision better?
This is what I recorded in all day long.
It's green, but it might be better.
It's green and you have the devil red eyes.
This is green wine. It's green wine. I mean,
I don't know where mom went. Maybe she went to smoke. Brent, you have work to do. Jan has been there for worse. Are you finding everywhere they go? Slowly but surely you're finding where they all go.
This is my boss. And the bird is mine.
Jimmy!
Don't encourage her.
This is making me sick with the camera.
I think a lot of people are. I'm not sure.
Where is?
I'm just letting it. I am sitting.
Kelly, I want you to know that. Kelly.
Tom is collecting all the liquor.
Yes, but he's still yet to pour me a glass of it. Kelly, I want you to know that your boyfriend is the first man that I ever dirty danced with.
I'm so tired. We've got things like we get ready. Somebody's not behind the curtain. I've got things scattered everywhere. I don't know where my key is. I don't know where my jewelry is.
This is a perfect shot. It's the top of the bottle and the corks, and both of you sitting there.
Your whole bottle of wine. Still with a hand.
I said this is what I've been doing. But hand. But hand.
Did this sound like audio?
Yeah.
They're trying to figure out what's going on.
I don't know. Janine. What is going on over there?
I don't know.
Janine, do you have two beds in your room?
Our room was for three, not four, baby.
I don't think that would happen.
Mom, did you have fun? She got to dance with my dad, which just never happens.
Is that bags under my eyes?
Janine, I think we earned our stripes today. We need like a badge for this wedding.
We need chocolate.
I think I've had more chocolate the last couple days than I've had in a long time.
What?
still is.
Yeah.
Bottom. It's nighttime, Tom.
Are you gonna do this?
You did an excellent video job.
Okay, hold on.
How are you doing?
There.
Now I can see in color.
It's color. Yeah. But well, you can't move very quickly because.
Oh, it gets all. Ah, it's like cops. It's like a cop's reenactment.
That's what I've been recording.
So the main question is, who is that? And what is happening with that hand?
Whose arm is that?
I don't know. This is what happens when Amy goes blonde. See, this is what happened and it goes blonde. I don't know what we're doing. We're hanging out right now. Enjoy your game! Bye!
Bye, Brent! We'll tape him.
Go out
there. Oh, you wanted like to say anything. Okay, thank you for calling. Is someone taking
I'm not.
Yeah, I got it.
Okay.
Okay. Hi.
Dun, 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 dun. Don, what game are you going to play?
Huh? We're going. Yeah, bye.
Get out of here, you crazy cats.
Ooh, I got to get the getaway. Escaping in the Xterra.
Brad, this is
Look
your
at all those presents.
You, right?
My car?
Yeah. Nice.
Look at all the presents in the back.
Jason Faye needs his...
Hey, Brent.
You
Brent.
Stop it.
Just so you know, the combined... Not that you're worried about it right now. I should make up for the $70 that I still owe you.
Oh, okay.
Go! Go!
We need Holly? You said something like that?
Where are we going?
Nobody wants you to sign.
No.
No, someone's going to take her home.
Oh, I don't know. Did she ask you to?
No, but she's...
Someone will take her by her the house. If no one else will, I'll take her by the house.
Can you take Jason Faye and make sure he gets his jeans and his shoes?
Where?
From the... my house. My house.
I'll work on
well,
it.
Well, if you take Holly, he's there.
Yeah. Yeah.
Make sure he gets
they
it.
Can follow us. Are they driving?
Yes.
Okay. Cool. Dawn? Wait, I'm taping. Hi!
Are you coming though?
Oh, it's on.
Yeah. Am I following you guys?
Are you coming?
Where are you guys going?
To Brent's house.
Yeah. Are you gonna?
Are you gonna
my
come?
Car is up there. Are you gonna wait for me?
Do you want to ride to
my,
your car?
Good high school friend went to college.
My car is up the hill. It's right over there.
It was a prank, but...
Are you gonna come?
I'm gonna come.
Okay, because you have to say goodbye to me, because I will never see you again, probably.
Whatever.
Okay.
Maybe never in Camden, Maine.
You're coming, Tom?
I'm coming.
Okay. All right.
You apparently went too far. I'm trying to catch up. Or something.
We're here at Brent's house.
trying to pick up.
Get a film on those two over there.
They're pretty neat. I tried.
Occasionally.
Yes, we would like to invite everyone to our mansion, and we have celebrities
come. Well, we haven't
come.
Decided between our
like
estate
you all.
In Minnesota or our place in the suburbs of Chicago. Or the penthouse.
I think
Chicago.
We'd have to go to Chicago in the
I
suburbs.
Think the penthouse would be
if
really
you want to come visit, you got to come to the Chicago.
We're in the
suburbs.
Building that the Four Seasons Hotel is in.
For
the,
sure.
The top floor. It's a
penthouse.
A two floor. No, two floors. Not just penthouse. It's the second floor below that. It's adequate. It would be adequate.
It would be adequate for
it
us.
It would be adequate.
What we like.
You know.
But
for you guys, it would be hard to come up with something that was good enough. But. You know, if we actually brought you all in first class and
you fly us in on your private jet.
No, I think first class on a commercial carrier. It's a little bit unsafe coming in.
Yeah.
It's a little bit unsafe coming
in
on private.
In Minnesota,
all those private things crash all the time.
True.
This is my best man.
Oh,
Tom.
And he
you live in St. Louis.
Yes. Big arts, like McDonald's bag. Not really golden though.
Not golden.
Not golden. Kind of white. Is it white?
It's
silver.
Silver? Silver? White? Stone? Stone? What is it? I've never seen it. Tell
aluminum.
Us. It is aluminum?
I don't know.
Aluminum.
I just moved there. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, you got that too, yes.
Yeah, I think she wants aluminum.
Wire.
Yes. Zoomed
in. It ting.
That was
glass.
Oh, see, I wasn't...
Yeah.
And then, I remember these from yesterday.
See, it's so hard.
But it sure does.
Where did I think it was?
St. Louis? No.
Nice.
You can't grab your own boob. It doesn't count.
You can grab your own boob.
If it doesn't count.
Why?
Because somebody else has to be doing it.
Why?
Because someone else has to be doing it. Because it's more fun that way. No, please.
Is it?
I'm not into that kind of fun.
Is it always more fun?
I think so.
Really, why? Tell us why.
It depends on the guy. Sometimes you're right, it's not more fun. Because sometimes they get lost. But other than that, aside from those small guys, then it is usually more fun should there be somebody else involved.
You already got it.
No, you weren't.
Yeah.
No, he really was. If you watch all the way to the end of the movie, you can see him from behind.
I'm in.
See,
I'll probably need a week to clean the house and find everything that everybody's
seen. Oh my god! She wants to go.
Yes. And the random empty beer glasses.
Oh wait, one more time.
We'll get it all.
No, camera. He's shooting her head, forehead.
What are you doing?
Hey, Tom, now I know why you're getting so close to the camera. I can see how it works.
Do you want me to strip? Will that help?
She just went all the way down.
Look at her! Standing.
They said get them hooking up. That's what I'm doing.
I'm standing next to him.
I know.
Okay, where are they? Who are you? Can I meet you? I'm
hot. Here's the photographer, the hot photographer that's been taping everybody all night tonight.
Who's
what's
that?
His story? Let's
what
find
is
out
your
a little
story?
Bit about
you. Some
what
little bit about
you.
No.
We
want to
learn a little bit about you.
Tell me about
why don't you say something for the bride and groom?
Let us tell you something about what we think
that's
about
fine.
The bride and the groom. They are the cutest couple.
Yeah, they are.
Cutest in the world. We came here from Minnesota and from Illinois. We are
in Chicago.
What, different states you mean? You mean being from different states?
No!
I'm from Minnesota tonight. I'm not from Chicago, Illinois.
Look, this wedding has resulted in another wedding.
I caught the garter. Would you stop that?
She
I caught the garter. She caught the bouquet. I mean, I caught the bouquet. She caught the garter. It's been really fun. Thank you very much for having us here tonight.
We love you.
We love you very much.
We will invite you to all of our superstar parties when we meet, like, George Clooney.
No,
we wish you all the love and success.
What's a good girl that Brent will meet?
Nicole
Kidman. Whenever we meet him, we will invite you to our parties.
Oh, it's all about who you know, not what you know.
Yeah. Jameen, what do you have to say?
No, we're not.
Wait a minute. Just Cameron's been on me a couple times earlier today. I still don't have anything to say.
Do not.
I know you do.
Come back to me. Let me get creative.
Okay.
You can't switch teams like that.
Me too?
Did you know that he's gay?
According to Seinfeld.
Oh my God.
You can't do
you
that.
You are?
Excuse me. Is that you?
No, it's her.
Amy.
Well, I was making the Seinfeld reference.
Amy, you lost. Drink it.
You can't switch teams. It doesn't work. You can't. You have to stay on the same team.
Drink
what are you doing?
Drink it now.
According to you.
I don't know what they're talking about.
Oh, nice.
She's like, what do I do? What do I do? I drink it!
Say something to your brother.
Eight.
Hi, Donner.
That's her little nickname.
How do you know it?
God, I'm not Donner.
Like yes, catch this on tape, please.
This big. Don, I've been friends for a long time.
Oh. Come on, guys.
It's a cute little thing you guys have.
You see, you're on
this is how our relationship
right
works.
No. This is live.
S&M. No, he just strangles me until he gets what he wants.
That's terrible.
There's nothing wrong with that.
Happy marriage. Compromise.
Nothing wrong with a little S&M.
Right.
Recommend it.
Dude, Brent, take pointers.
Have a good marriage.
Yeah, Taylor's like, I hope you can hold it out for at least a year.
Year. 1 year. Just for 1 year. And you beat 50% of America.
That was the best part of your speech. You're like, I hope you're ready for what's to come over the next year.
Oh, right. All right.
I mean, years.
They don't need any encouragement because they're a wonderful couple.
Brent and Dawn, I just hope that you continue to have the magic stick throughout your relationship. I got the magic stick, and if I can hit once, I can hit twice.
You know what, I'm gonna tell a little joke here, all right? We thought after Cordell left, we'd have no more Steelers taken in the ass.
I know if I could lick once, I could lick twice. I got the magic stick.
Oh my God.
Uh-huh, what? Magic. You don't know what you just participated in. But
I
thank
don't.
You.
Right. You're welcome. And cheer.
Joey Porter.
Hey, that was a funny joke.
What is that?
I think I'm a little older than you.
Are we going to a toga party now?
Toga.
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 It's okay, Tom.
You love me, Tom. You know it. Oh, you know. I'm a white wine girl. No monologues for me tonight. Brendan, I'm really happy for you, and I'm glad that you live in Maine now, because you and Brent and Chris are really close, and I'm hoping that we can hang out together and get to know each other more, because I think you're really great people. So come to Portland and hang out, and every time we're in Camden, we'll make sure we call you. Love you guys.
There you go.
That's cute.
See?
I'm going down to get Holly some beer right now. You stay in here and you drink wine, and we're going out for some beer. Would you like us to bring you a beer?
Yes.
Okay, we'll get you one. We'll be back in a few minutes. Bye.
All right. I love you.
Okay, we need to clarify something. John and Brent. Okay, Brent. You need to train Don a little bit better, because it was just brought to our attention that your entire Iowa table, they all ordered the lobster bake.
And
the reason,
casserole.
Yeah, because Dawn, you know, you've been here since, February. You're almost a Mainer, and you told them that this came as a baked casserole type dish.
You look good on TV.
That's not what a lobster bake is. I look good?
You do.
She's like, you do. She looks at least 23.
So you should be ashamed of yourself.
22.
You mortified your entire
24.
Iowa table when they got this
BDI
crustacean
sure
in a bag. That's all I have to say.
Brian had to come to my table.
So
and
for your first anniversary
ate.
Party, get it right.
And I too was expecting casserole.
And I know what a lobster bake is.
Amy, wow. Do it again, Amy.
No, I've only done it three times.
Again.
I'm a conservative girl.
That's what I told you. We have to
this conversation on tape about how grabbing yourself is never good. And she's like, wait, never good? I said, well, it depends on some guys. Sometimes they get lost.
I'd say give you a white shirt.
Only in those few
Aside from those few gentlemen.
Isolated.
Right.
Anybody else speeches like before I put this?
I do agree.
No, that was just that was the deal. That was it.
Good, honey. And, that was so profound.
I didn't mean for him to turn the camera on me while I was saying
that. That was it. We're done.
No.
We're done. Goodbye. Have a good life.
Every time our eyes meet, this feeling inside me is almost more than I can take. Baby, when you touch me, I can feel how much you love me, and it just blows me away. I've never been this close to anyone or anything. I can hear your thoughts, I can see your dreams. I don't know how you do what you do. I'm so in love with you. It just keeps getting better. I wanna spend the rest of my in my heart. Oh, it feels like the first time, every time. I wanna spend the rest of